5'8", 145 pounds, big driver.
Schmidty, happy 60th. Three things Billy wants me to relay that I remember most of our relationship. Number one, I beat you in 9 holes of golf. Thanks, Natalie. Two, we are the reigning Rolling Ridge Golf Champions. Thanks for helping out. And three, how lucky you were to have a locker next to me freshman year of high school. Think how your life would have changed if that didn't happen. Have a great birthday. Love you, man.
One of the first memories that comes to mind when I think about Schmidty, Uncle Schmidty, in my case, is, I must have been about 9 years old up at Horseshoe Bay. My dad and Schmidty were playing in the member guest, and I had heard that they won it. So I went down to find them, and I found them on the 18th hole. Oh, wait, that was Billy that won the member guest with my dad. That's right. In all seriousness, there's a lot of great memories that come to mind when I think about Schmidty, but there's two that stand out. The first being when he caddied for me in the Western Junior Amateur. I didn't have anybody that would come down for 2 days and caddy for me, and Schmidty raised his hand last minute and was able to do it. Now, in true Schmidty fashion, he showed up on the 5th hole of the first round, a little bit late, 2 hours or so late, but it meant the world to me that he came and did it. We had a blast, as we always do when we're together. The second one is Schmidty agreeing to be my confirmation sponsor. Now, some may question that choice as my confirmation sponsor, but he made the process a lot easier. We had a lot of fun doing it, and it got us a lot closer as, uncle, nephew in our case. Happy birthday, Schmidty. I'm happy you made it to 60. I'm happy that your hair color finally caught up with your age, since you've had that for about 40 years. Love you, man. Can't wait to see you. Hope to see you soon. Happy birthday, buddy. Side note, I'm making this film on Halloween, and this was my work Halloween costume, so.
Let's go, girls. Come on. I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling all right. Gonna let it all hang out. Wanna make some noise. Really raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout.
Happy birthday, Schmidty. Welcome to 60. It's just a number, remember. Hey, you and I have been friends longer than any of the knobs. It's great to share a couple memories. They'll go high school. My fun memories of you, Schmidty, is when we were in grade school. Do you remember when they were building the new church, and they had the billboard with the supports going off the back, and it was right on our football field? And so, sure enough, at least once a week, somebody would throw a bomb and you'd try to run under it right into those supports and knock yourself out. And it got to be a joke after a while. Yeah, Schmidty knocked himself out again, and they'd have to carry you into the cafeteria. Yeah, that was fun memories. Or when we play basketball, whether it was at your house or at my house, one of the fun memories that I remember is When you blocked Steve's shot, we were playing Hustle, and you blocked his shot from behind. And then you got the ball and you went up for a layup or something, and he caught you one hand, you know, through the crotch and the other one over the shoulder, and he walked you right into a bush and dumped you into the middle of the bush. Okay, that was really fun memories. So anyway, just so many memories, so many fun times with you. You know, you truly are a brother from another mother. And so I just want to wish you a happy birthday and, you know, welcome you to the club. And remember, we are the original Knobs. And so, hey, happy 60th.
Good night.
My best memories of my buddy Schmidty. Are they good memories? Or are they bad memories? Or just memories? Now here's a good memory. High school football. Our 125-pound wide receiver, who every once in a while had to play tight end. We're in practice, and I hear this noise. We were running a running play to Schmidty's side, and that was Schmidty making the sounds of blocking. When Schmidty blocks, Schmidty squeals. Whole team was on the ground laughing. So apparently our buddy Schmidty mastered the concept of remote work long before it became fashionable. 2010, Horseshoe Bay member guest. We're driving out to the first tee to get the tournament started. Schmidty's nowhere to be found. Sending him text messages, trying to call him. Nope, he's downstairs in the clubhouse taking a work call. Finally, I find him and we're driving out to the tee and I said, Schmidty, you gotta put your phone away. We can't be playing in this tournament and you on the phone all the time. He's like, Rick, my boss doesn't know I'm here. 3 days with Schmidty, on and off the phone, playing in the tournament. We won our flight. We didn't win the tournament, but it's a memory I'll never forget. Maybe that's why he's had so many jobs. So is it just me, or is it everybody that gets tired of Schmidty sending pictures of all of his trophy deer that he shot over the years? Take a look at this. Now these are trophies, my friend. Happy birthday, Schmidty. Can't believe you're 60. Holy shit.
This is the best idea we've ever had before.
Now on the tee box from Dousman, Wisconsin, Jeff Schmidt.
Schmidty, you're the man! Go get him, Schmidty!
Come on, Schmidty!
Go, Schmidty! In the hole!
What I'm trying to do is pop it up. Drive.
Last night,
were you drinking with Schmidty again?
No.
Happy 60th to my dreamboat, Schmidty. You know, 60 is the new 56, according to the Social Security Administration. Congrats on 4 more years of work on top of the 2 you already had left. Love you, buddy.
Let's set sail with Captain Morgan. Oh, and never leave dry land. Hey, troubles, I forgot 'em.
when our illustrious King of the Knobs asked for some memories for Jeff, specific memories each of us have had. Three popped up immediately. I know there's many more. I guess the first one would be one of the first times we met. Jeff, remember with driving instructor Tom Sawyer, driving, he came to pick me up and you were in the back seat and I'm driving down the highway about 80 miles an hour and he calmly mentioned that possibly we might want to slow down just a little bit. You were laughing in the back seat. I always remember that. That was the first time that we met, and we've talked about that before too. The other thing was things such as meeting early in the morning for breakfast after being out and having your fingers in my food, like let's say on the over easy eggs, you know, mentioning it might resemble one of your girlfriends possibly. I always enjoyed when your fingers were in my food. And the last thing would be, I'll never forget this because it still haunts me, the one and only time that I actually so came close to beating you in golf. Pine Acres, 9 holes we played. I shot a 38, and the last hole I was up by 1, and I hit the green. You were off the green, and I two-putted from about 10 feet, and you chipped in. I don't really want to talk about it anymore. But buddy, have a good birthday. Happy 60th, and hope we all can get together soon, somehow. You guys take care. All right, Jeff. Love you, buddy.
What are you thinking? What's the thought process here?
I'm hitting about a knockdown driver right here. Tears in his eyes.
Schmidty, almost 5 decades now of friendship. Let's take a little trip down memory lane, shall we? Schmidty, we met at 12 years old, playing on Little League All-Star teams opposite each other. Then at 13, 14, 15, we played Babe Ruth baseball and we were the All-Stars representing that team. Then in high school, one of my favorite stories of all time was junior year Schneid's pick to the All-Star team. And you and I corral a couple of Boy Scouts together, a couple dozen. And we say, hey, that guy over there, number 14, go over there and ask for his autograph. We're sitting up in the stands. All the Boy Scouts go over, only to Schneid. And Schneid turns around like, this is the greatest thing ever, and starts signing autographs, patting kids on the head, totally acting the role. He gets to the last few, and we are cracking up in the stands. And he looks up and sees us and realizes what we did to him. And then, of course, as seniors, then we represented the team as the All-Stars. And one of my favorite things we used to do to just drive Schneid crazy was when I'd call timeout and run to the mound and we'd have our little huddle and we'd talk. And I'd start talking about the 57 there in the crowd. I'd start talking about somebody's anniversary, what their mom was wearing up there, what their dad said, and it would just drive Schneid crazy that we weren't taking things serious. Love that. And by the way, don't think for a minute that I don't realize that the star on my jersey is starting to look kind of like an asterisk. It's a little tight, I get it. Of course, high school football. So many stories, so many memories. A couple of my favorites. You and I were at football camp at lacrosse, and they were running essentially offense against defense with no linemen. And the guy running the camp says to the defense and the offense, and we're all gathered and we're about to start, says, look, this isn't about home runs and bombs and everybody trying to be superheroes here. You run good routes, you throw good balls, you defend appropriately. So we go over, get back in the huddle, and I'm the quarterback in the first run, you're my receiver. And the guy gets in the huddle and he says, all right, kid, you go long, and points at you. I think I threw like a 50, 60 yarder for a touchdown. And the defense was pissed off. We get back in the huddle and the guy looks at us. He goes, well, let's do it again. So we did it again and scored again. It was amazing. And it was so amazing how you were always so wide open. And how do I know this? Because every time you came back to the huddle, you told me how wide open you were. There's a mark on my legacy as the quarterback at Premontre. I would have had a 4-touchdown pass game against Oshkosh. And I hit you on about a 45, 50 yarder, and you tripped on the 2-yard line. Hard one to take. Then came the college years. I think someone that we knew at the time said it the most appropriately and the most aptly as it related to us. And the quote was, "Schmidty and Billy, when you guys are together, you do the dumbest things." It's so true. We had some great times. I remember playing tennis and I threw my back out and we only had my motorcycle there and you didn't know how to drive a motorcycle. So I got on the back, you had to take me back to the dorms. Of course, there's the red whirling light hat in the traffic jam. There was the 2-for-$1 Whoppers. And after we finished them, we jammed them underneath my seat in my car for an entire year to see how many we could get under there. It was a wild, wild time. And what we could do with saltines, nobody else could do. Then, of course, came our party years. Man, did we take to drinking. My favorite story was the time I passed out at Menominee. And you apparently dragged me across 4 lanes of traffic and up and down 2 snowbanks and let me lay there in the snowbank. What a friend. But the next day, we're headed to a Gopher game in the cities. And I'm in the back seat and I am just dying. And I said, I looked at you and I said, "Schmidty, you gotta get me something in there." So you go in and get this big bottle of Tums. Come back out the car, you hand it to me. We're about hour and a half into our drive and you got the Tums bottle in your hand. And I've been eating Tums and you read the label says, "Should not take more than 8 of these in a 24-hour period." I had half the bottle gone, so you did try to kill me. In our adult lives, we continue to do stupid things, like Easter egg hunts where I filled the eggs for your kids with baking powder, real eggs, paprika, and they would open them up. I love the memory of, I think it was Lindsay was standing next to you and I and realized that I had filled the eggs with like real stuff. And she sees off in the distance, Natalie and James opening eggs and she runs like it's in slow motion. "No, don't open the eggs, Uncle Bill put." And then of course, one of them, I think it was James, opened an egg right next to you and it was a windy day and it covered you in, I think it was baking powder. Great memory. But you've only known me as your king for all these adult years. And a painful memory of mine, something that you took away from me that strikes at the heart of who I am, was in 2019, after 41 years reigning as the king, I realize it's self-proclaimed king, but I was still king. You decided to have a contest to see who would be king. And that chicken-ass bitch, Billy, became the king. It's been a wild ride, Schmidty. Thanks for the memories, the fun, the friendship, the brotherhood. I love you, and happy birthday to you.
Hey, Billy, these guys aren't that good. It's all about you and me. Remember those days at Stout?
Yeah, hey there.
Hey! Oh, we miss you?
Who?
Nobody.
Hey, you know what I was thinking? Who do we miss?
Nobody!
So, tennis edition. Who do we miss, guys?
Nobody!
Okay, good. So, who we missing?
Nobody!